The woman next to me is the Prime Minister of Finland. She's 36 years old and she is now considered a baddie because she went clubbing all night during the coronavirus pandemic. First of all, she's 36 years old. Like, let that sink in for all the Americans who have Joe Biden as their leader. But anyway, this is what happened. So Marin, the prime minister here, 36 years old, is being called out for a lapse of judgment after she failed to return home from the bar on Saturday night upon learning that Foreign Minister Pekka Haavisto had tested positive for COVID. The two had actually been in close proximity just a day earlier. And so she was initially told that she didn't need to quarantine, that she didn't need to isolate because she had been fully vaccinated, but later missed a text message that advised her to do so. So these are her advisors. The thing is, they had apparently text messaged her on her work phone, which she left home when she was clubbing it up. Okay. I don't think that she like intentionally did something wrong. They had communicated with her earlier and told her that she didn't need to isolate, and then they tried to communicate with her later and she missed the message. Now, again, the text telling her to quarantine was sent to her work phone, which she didn't take to the club. When she saw the text, she quickly got a COVID test and luckily tested negative. And then she tested herself again for a second time, also tested negative. At first, Marin defended her actions, arguing that she had followed the advice of her Secretary of State, who informed her about the COVID exposure. But in a Facebook post on Monday, she said she should have double checked the guidance and used better judgment. I'm very sorry for not understanding that I needed to do that, she wrote. So she has apologized for it. And in terms of the guidelines, I think that's also an important component of the story. What's happening in Finland, especially since other countries are very different from here, the United States. The guidelines do advise people to voluntarily avoid social contact if they're waiting to access a COVID test. Separate guidelines for government ministers and employees also recommended limiting social contact immediately after exposure, according to a Finnish newspaper.
Okay, I have two things to say in the beginning here. First of all, let her go, let her go. We're gonna do a poll on this, tyt.com/polls. Curious what you think. It's actually, there are good points on both sides, which we'll get to in a second. The second thing I have to say is, look, to be fair to her, why did she leave her work phone behind? Because she was finished with it.
She was finished with work. She was going to the club. No, I. Listen, I'm happy that she's taking it seriously, and I know, yes. I don't give you your due diligence. I'm sorry.
Okay, that was it's great. Okay. I got love from Craig.
It was
I'm
a
good.
Great joke.
I'm
Craig, good. Now you're making me look bad.
Okay, no, you don't have
for
to laugh and finish
cheesy jokes.
Jokes.
All right. I'm just impressed that she likes to go clubbing at 36.
Yes. Oh, at 36. That's
yeah,
funny.
Because I'm 35.
Because you think that's old, and for to go clubbing.
For clubbing?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think 36 is old to go clubbing. Like, I'm not hating on her, I'm impressed. I can't imagine at 35 wanting to be at a club. I like to dance, but I like to dance in air, like I like open spaces.
Okay.
I don't want people like crammed near me. I don't want bottle service. I don't want any of that.
So you're finished with clubbing.
I'm finished with that. It's okay. I've been finished.
Okay. So look, the reason why it's complicated is, as the prime minister, yes, when your foreign minister tests positive, you probably should take a couple more precautions and you probably should have your phone, business phone on you because of that, not every single time. Actually, when you're prime minister, you probably should have your business phone on you all the time, right? It sucks,
no,
but it's true.
You should, yeah, absolutely,
yeah.
I agree.
And so on the other hand, how awesome is it that their prime minister is actually fun and doesn't hate, it just works for the donors and right? And she's out clubbing till 4 a.m. I love her for
that. Not just that, they're doing way better in responding to COVID than we are, far less deaths than the United States.
tyt.com/polls, you be the judge. But I say, let her go! Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.